The second curve is an embarrassingly simple notion. It's based on a book I did about 15, 20 years ago, actually, now. And the notion is very simple. The argument is that most businesses in most industries are going along quite nicely on the first curve, which is the business they know how to operate on a daily basis. It's where they make all their profit and revenue. But they have a sneaking suspicion in their gut that that curve is going to decline in absolute or relative terms. So the first curve coming down might be not a reduction in revenue, but a reduction in growth rate or a reduction in margin, if you're speaking in a business sense. And the argument is that that anxiety is really about the replacement of the first curve by a second curve, a new business or a new way of doing business that is radically different from the first. Now, the dirty little secret of futurism is that we cannot actually predict the future. And there's a natural human tendency to overestimate the impact of phenomena in the short run and underestimate it in the long run. So what you do is you commit two types of strategic errors. You panic and you walk away prematurely from that first curve, only to walk away from all the profit and revenue. Conversely, if you don't start building that second curve, you're not going to be around later on in the 21st century. You know, many industries have gone through this because of the combination of globalization, the internet, new consumers who are more skeptical, more demanding, and yet healthcare has been sort of left out of that transformation. Now, I think healthcare is truly embracing the second curve, and to the point where the American Hospital Association and other groups have used this metaphor to describe the transformation that's underway now in American healthcare. And really, in terms of the second curve, what that means for healthcare is the first curve is the old model of fee-for-service delivered through, you know, independent physicians in small and solo practice, to a second curve where we're seeing large, organized, integrated systems of care who are operating on a population health basis. The phrase people use a lot is we're moving from a first curve of paying for volume to a second curve of paying for value. The trouble is, as in all first to second curve transformations, is the uncertainty about the pace of change. We have clarity about the direction, many believe, but we are really uncertain about how to get from here to there. And that's the dilemma, I think, that it really is at this core of where most large hospital systems and delivery systems generally are at this time.